Hello and welcome to day two here at the 2019 BioInvestor Forum here in San Francisco. I'm Christine Corrado with Proactive Investors. Joining me right now is Westbrook Weaver. He's the founder and CEO of Tempo Therapeutics. Westbrook, great to meet you.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Why don't you first start off with telling me a bit about the company?
Absolutely. So Tempo is a seed stage startup company based in San Diego in California, and we are developing material science therapies for regenerative medicine. So kind of taking a different approach, cell-free, biologic-free, really focusing on developing physical material scaffolds for tissue repair. And we're using a unique technology, which we call the MAP technology, that allows us to be able to create a synthetic material, fully synthetic and foreign, that you can inject into the damaged area of tissue, and it's not recognized as foreign by the immune system, which allows us to really take a sort of unique approach to cell-free therapies for tissue repair.
What is the current kind of standard of care right now to treat with the area that you're in?
Yeah, it's interesting. So there's a lot of different areas that we're potentially going into, everything from complex skin wounds to cardiovascular to CNS. But in terms of our first focus, which is complex skin wounds, the standard of care is actually kind of abysmal. There's really not any advanced therapies that are used very regularly. There are a lot of animal-derived and human-derived tissues that are kind of repurposed for this use, which is very limiting in terms of how they're applied, typically as sheets or powders, and very expensive to manufacture and make. So we're kind of trying to take a different approach of synthetically creating materials that are flowable and injectable, minimally invasive, and again, that are not recognized as foreign and not rejected. That's really the key.
How big of a market is this? How many, I guess, amputations are performed per year?
So good question. So in terms of the complex skin wounds, really what's happening is these folks that have really difficult to heal wounds end up going into the operating room, end up undergoing either partial amputations or sometimes full amputations. And full amputations that are a result of these complex skin wounds, we're looking at about 150,000 a year in the U.S. alone. So those are the cases where limb salvage therapy has failed. And that's where really we want to go in and help these patients who are receiving limb salvage therapy actually keep their limbs rather than losing them.
What kind of studies have you done in the past? Where are you right now with that?
Yeah, good question. So we're actually preclinical right now with this first product. We've done all of our preclinical studies, both safety, tox, and performance in animal studies, as well as actually having already entered into the animal health market. So we're actually using our product to treat complex wounds in canines.
Oh, wow.
And we've been doing that in the San Diego and Sacramento area for about a year now. And that's actually helped us develop a lot of early data to help us understand how the product works, what's its real functionality. And also it provides really good model data for what's going to happen, hopefully, in humans. And we're actually entering into the clinical study in 2020 for our first product, which we're calling TT101.
And what's kind of the strategy of being here? Are you looking for partners, looking for funding?
Yeah. So here at the BioInvestor Forum, we're looking for venture partners for a Series A that we're raising. We're looking to raise $10 million to finance both this clinical study for our first product, as well as continue pipeline development for our soft tissue products for oncoplastic surgeries, as well as our cardiovascular product.
Yeah. I mean, you mentioned, right, this is a platform technology. Yeah. Investors should really kind of be attracted to something like that. How would that kind of work in CNS diseases and cardiovascular diseases?
It's a great question. So we are really developing a material for tissue repair, and tissue needs repairing in a lot of different scenarios, whether or not it's a simple skin wound or a complex skin wound, or, for example, heart attack, heart failure that can progress to heart failure. What we would be doing and have shown already is that if you inject our material into the actual myocardium, you can reduce inflammation, slow scar progression, and actually result in increased cardiac output simply because you're able to create new myocardial tissue with the scaffold. Similarly in CNS, we've actually done a lot of early studies in stroke treatment, as well as spinal cord injury to help reduce inflammation, reduce scar, and allow the innate cells that are present in our bodies, like neural progenitor cells, to grow into those damaged sites and reform new tissue. And so it's kind of the same concept in a lot of these different tissues: reduce inflammation, reduce scar formation, and provide a scaffold that can build new tissue simply because it's not rejected as foreign by the immune system.
Well, it seems super interesting, Westbrook. Definitely excited to follow your accomplishments. Thank you so much for sitting down with
me. Yeah, thank you. We really appreciate it. We're really excited. It's early stages for us at the company, but it's really cool to be able to have a new technology that, you know, really kind of changes the way that you would approach even doing tissue repair. So we're really excited for that.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Awesome.